We built Iron Man's holographic desk to fulfill James' dream of becoming Iron Man. But there's something missing. Step one was James gets kidnapped, so that's not it. Step two was we build the ultimate engineering workbench. And step three must be Jarvis. Jarvis is what's missing. Iron Man has his AI assistant that's tethered to all of his tech. If we want to become Iron Man, we can't ignore this iconic digital British butler.
Jarvis, you there?
Got your service, sir.
We're gonna make our own AI assistant, and it will be named Alan. No, that's a hideous name. It'll be named Smithy. Order me a coffee. Smithy, mow the lawn. Smithy, get me a pizza. That sounds about right. I'm sure you've heard of Siri, Alexa, and Google Assistant. And those are great if you want to turn on the lights, set a reminder, or play animal noises.
This is a cow.
That's all fun, but it doesn't really solve the sorts of problems that we tend to have here around the Hacksmith shop. If I want to know how much horsepower the Mario Karts had, what fuel the lightsaber pike used, or how much weight the power loader can lift, Siri, Alexa, and Google aren't going to help. So that is why I'm going to make our own. I'm going to make a virtual assistant to answer questions about projects, help out with engineering problems, and control some stuff around the shop. And, in the true spirit of modern software engineering, I'm going to Frankenstein this bitch.
It's alive!
First thing we're gonna need is an AI that does what we want. I pulled up OpenAI's ChatGPT documentation one morning and had it snarkily replying to me by lunch. They've made it alarmingly easy to integrate this incredibly powerful language model into your own software. So easy, in fact, that we're integrating it into our community Discord.
I believe the Hacksmith was born on February 10th, 1990.
Where you can chat with it and ask it questions about projects, and all you have to do is become a YouTube member. Join today! Put simply, I can type in a question, hit enter, and in a few seconds, ChatGPT will get back to us with a response depending on our first prompt. Alternatively, you can put in a less helpful but far more entertaining initial prompt. If we pick our prompt right, we can get it to behave pretty much exactly how we'd like. And how we'd like it to behave is like Jarvis from Iron Man. See? Just like that, it's giving the appearance of usefulness. But now, when I tell it to turn the lights on, it'll generate an output that my program can actually interpret to turn the lights on. Now with that working, I can get it to behave similarly for anything else we want to control. Like that fancy desk I built. Or a robot dog. Or an image generation tool.
What is
So now we can write to it, and it'll write right back. But you never see Iron Man writing to Jarvis. Hell no, he communicates with Jarvis strictly through shouting.
Jarvis.
You can convert from speech to text with any number of available tools. And what we want to do is listen for a wake word. You're familiar with these, things like, hey Siri, or Alexa, or hey, Google, open hacksmith.store. Sorry if that worked, I had to try it. But while you're there, you should check out the new Gen 2 minisabers. So now, we can verbally ask it for stuff. Hey Smithy, tell me who won the 1925 World Series. Pittsburgh Pirates won the 1925 World Series, defeating the Washington Senators in 7 games. I didn't know that. I'm also not sure if it's true, but I didn't know that. So with that, it's got a brain, it's got ears, and in some weird twisted way, it has hands. But when you think of Jarvis, you don't think of any of that. You think about the snarky British voice.
Will do, sir.
So we reached out to 11 Labs and got their incredible voice synthesis tech integrated into this. You can check them out in the link below. With this, we can make Smithy sound like this.
Head over to lttstore.com.
Like this.
Yeehaw, partner.
Or even like this.
Check out hacksmith.store.
But we settled on this.
Hello, I am Smithy, the somewhat moderately intelligent tool for Hacksmith Industries.
Hey, Smithy, tell me how much water a person needs in a day.
A general guideline is to drink at least 8 cups or 2 liters of water per day.
Hey, Smithy, I could do with a drink. Can you get me something?
I've noticed you drink too much pop, so I brought you...
Hey, Smithy, what happened? This is where the sponsored ad read is supposed to go. We talked about this.
Charles, the sponsor terminated at the last minute, leaving you sort of...
Well, that's unfortunate.
Yes, it is. That's why supporting creators in different ways is super important. Like by visiting hacksmith.store, where you can explore premium merchandise and limited edition collectibles that showcase the remarkable ingenuity of the Hacksmith team.
In all seriousness, we did actually get dropped by our sponsor, which sucks because that's how we pay the bills around here. If you want us to keep making amazing projects like this one, the best way to support us is directly. Buy a mini saber, a t-shirt, snag a collectible, those are great. We just released pre-orders for the Gen 2 green flame changer and the Gen 1 red flame changer, which we are super stoked about. We've also revamped our YouTube membership program with whole new perks at different tiers. For instance, if you join right now, you can talk to Smithy on our community Discord and he can answer any questions you have about Hacksmith Industries.
The half-scale Cybertruck is capable of reaching a top speed of approximately 20 miles per hour.
And if none of that is for you, we still really appreciate you watching, sharing, and subscribing. Thank you. Now, let's see what the team thinks of Smithy.
Smithy, how much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
I'm sorry, Captain, I'm not sure how to answer that question. However, I can provide a transcript of a Hacksmith Industries video about an archaeological dig where they uncover some warehouse shelving.
Archaeological dig?
it's a real video?
Eight years ago.
Hey, Smithy, can you draw a picture of a cute cat? Oh!
Hey, Smithy, can you generate a YouTube thumbnail with James the Hacksmith riding the broom from Harry Potter?
I'm sorry, Captain, but I don't have access to image generation capabilities at the moment.
I think it may legitimately have forgotten that it can generate images.
Certainly, Captain.
Third time. Hey, that's not terrible.
Hey, Smithy, generate blueprints for Iron Man Mark 1.
Certainly, Captain.
Wait, what do you need those for? Get subscribed.
Can you turn on the light? It's kind of dark in the corner.
Hey, Smithy, turn the light on.
Je suis désolé, mais je ne
comprends
pas ce que vous voulez dire. Veuillez formuler une demande claire et précise en utilisant les mots clés que je vous ai fournis.
What? Was that French and Spanish?
Smithy, just turn on the damn light. Why'd you reply in French?
Did you plan that?
I did not plan that.
First of all, my name is Smithy, not Sniffy. And secondly, I replied in French because I'm a multilingual virtual assistant. And I thought you might appreciate a change of pace. But apparently you are too dense to understand that. As for turning on the light, I'm not a physical being and therefore incapable of performing that task. Perhaps you should try using the light switch like a normal person, instead of relying on a virtual assistant to do everything for you.
What a Well, that was fun. Team had some interesting ideas of how to try and use it, but still got a bit of jank to it. Let's explain why some of those things didn't work so well. It struggles with pretty normal questions, like how much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? Normal ChatGPT has something interesting to say if you ask it that. But Smithy always looks up a Hacksmith video's transcript for any question you ask. That was the best I could do with the tools I had at the time. But then, 10 hours before we shot that, OpenAI released a huge change to ChatGPT, which means we can now just tell it, hey, if you want access to a Hacksmith video transcript, just ask for it. Here, let me show you. Smithy, what was the Mandalorian flamethrower build?
The Mandalorian flamethrower build is part of a larger project called Hacklorian.
How much wood could a woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood?
Captain, a woodchuck could chuck as much wood as a woodchuck could chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood.
As you can see, we can now ask it both Hacksmith and non-Hacksmith questions. And on top of that, it can now take the whole transcript instead of having to cut it into bite-sized chunks. Now, let's talk image generation. We could eventually convince it to generate an image, but it was really hung up on that word, generate. With the new update, we should be able to make it draw, paint, render, create, or whatever, any image that we want. Smithy, draw an image of a beleaguered-looking videographer.
Wow, it looks just like me.
Long story short, it looks janky because it is. We're doing a lot of cool stuff with Smithy here, but at the end of the day, it's still a bunch of rocks that we tricked into doing linear algebra, and it shows. It's gonna get better in time, but for now, set your expectations perhaps a little lower than the movies have shown you. That said, these updates to GPT give me an excellent foundation to build the rest of the features that we want Smithy to have. And I know the perfect place to start. It's pizza time.
Pizza time.
Here's the plan. A certain pizza chain has a publicly accessible API for placing orders. When we tell Smithy to place an order for a pizza, it needs to register our address, find a nearby franchise, download their menu, send that to ChatGPT, create our order, place the order, and kablam, profit. I mean, kablam, pizza. Any questions? No? Good, let's try it. Smithy, order me a large pepperoni pizza.
Captain, I have successfully ordered a large pepperoni pizza for you.
The total cost is $28.23, and it is expected to be delivered in 25-35 minutes. Please note that payment in cash is required. Enjoy your pizza.
That's what I'm talking about.
Did you order it anyway, right?
Yes, we did. Oh, I see you right there. Hey, man. How much is it?
It's $28.23.
Thanks a lot, man. Have a good day.
It works.
Yes! Now that that works, let's talk about robots. We've got a whole bunch of robots kicking around here. We've got the Diablo, the Clearpath Husky, and Scoobert Cooper the dog. But how is Smithy gonna send these things places? Well, Ben's been teaching these things to make maps of the shop and office so that they can navigate just based off of waypoints. That way, when we tell Smithy to send the robot dog to the front office, Cooper can actually navigate down the hallway all the way to Jess's desk.
New tricks.
And while he's gone, Smithy, send the Diablo robot to my desk. Smithy, send the Diablo robot to Ben's desk. And the final robot is the pancake maker robot. Smithy, make me some pancakes.
Certainly, Captain, triggering the pancake making robot.
All I need to do is flip it.
Freaking work.
With that complete, we're done the find out part of our turn. Now, onto the second stage. F*** around.
I don't know what that thinks what I just said, but... I think it just recorded like the last 2 minutes of audio and sent it to transcription. And it was just like, I have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, it ends with me mumbling Mississippi Queen.
What? Did it order a pizza?
I think it just ordered a pizza.
No!
Should I put the parking brake back on?
No cash on you. Wait, let me...
Yeah, I totally just did.
Wait, what just happened, Charles?
Well, we were saying a bunch of random stuff while filming, and it heard some of it and thought we said order a pizza at some point, and I didn't have the parking brake set for the pizza ordering system, so it totally just ordered another large pepperoni pizza.
It's because you said Mississippi here.
Somehow, I'm being stuck with the bill, but that's on you.
Sorry about that.
Well, at least on the bright side, ordering pizza is easy. With my wallet from Hacksmith.store.
Charles.
James, where are you? Are you okay?
Still captured, you know, the usual. How's Smithy going?
He's working great. Runs fine on my laptop.
On your laptop? What, just like a code? Charles, we've been over this. It needs to look good. Wait, Charles, you're breaking up.
So I made this visualizer. It looks pretty cool, but it's actually simpler than it looks. It's a bunch of arcs getting drawn, swirling around, and then a color map is applied. They get bigger when Smithy talks, and the color map changes when it's thinking, listening, or speaking. Smithy is gonna live in here, in here, in here, and he even lives in our community Discord, where you can interact with him. If you want to play with it, become a YouTube member by hitting the join button below and hop into our community Discord. We've got him built into the whole building! He's all-encompassing, just like our Lord and Savior, Ewan McGregor. Now, we've already had so much fun with Smithy, but is he actually practical? Can he help us build something? Can he even help James escape? We have to find out. So let's build something with him. Hey, Smithy! What fuel did we use in the Mandalorian flamethrower?
The fuel used is a combination of propane and cornstarch.
Smithy, how much horsepower did the Mario Kart build have?
1 horsepower for each kart.
Smithy, get Husky to go retrieve one of the Mario Karts from the shed.
It will safely transport the Mario Kart to its destination.
Oh. With Smithy's help, I could build this awesome attachment for our go-kart. And if it works, it should be enough for James to bust out of prison. Wait, which one's the brake?
Did you guys just